pretty much, sir, for giving me this opportunity to speak on a subject which is very important for Pakistan in front of such an august audience. Seldom we see such a large number of Pakistan's intellectual sitting in one place. So this is a great honor for me, sir. Now, the topic is basically U.S.-Pakistan's economic relationship. Can Pakistan survive without U.S. assistance? This is the topic. Okay. There are many former diplomats sitting here, so I will concentrate more on economic side, but there is a relationship between economics and political relations between the two nations. So in my view, economic and political relations are the mirror image of the relationship between the two countries. When economic ties are growing, it reflects the strengthening of political or diplomatic relationship between the two countries. And declining economic relations represents growing mistrust, distrust between the countries. It also represents the changing priorities. In Pakistan, we always say that pehle hum bade acche dost the, ab dekhe hume chhod gaye wo. In international relations, sir, it is a very dynamic relations. There is no permanent friend and no permanent foe. So it changes as your priorities changes. What is important is your interest. When the interest of the two countries will converge, there will be a good relationship and economic relationship will also flourish. When there is a divergence of interest, the reverse will happen. This is exactly what is happening with respect to Pakistan-US relationship. Why US is important for Pakistan? The reason is that US has been one of the major development partners of Pakistan for decades. Today, as you will see, this economic ties between the two countries are on the decline, and a very sharp decline. Today, Pakistan's total trade share, that is import plus export of Pakistan vis-a-vis United States, is only 8%. This is the latest number. US is Pakistan's largest export market. 17% of Pakistan's export go to the United States, and which amounts to $2.5 billion. Pakistan's imports from United States is only 4%. That is about $1.7 billion. So you can see that Pakistan has always maintained a surplus trade balance with the United States. We exported more to US than we imported from the United States. US is the third largest source of workers' remittances, close to $2.4 billion. In fact, as you will see in a moment, one-third remittance of Pakistan used to come from the United States only a few years ago. But it, as I said, that we are witnessing a very sharp decline in our economic ties. So it has declined to roughly 12.6% last year. United States is one of the major foreign investors in Pakistan, although the flow of foreign direct investment from US has declined drastically from $1.36 billion to only $13 million, $13 million last year. US is also important for Pakistan because it has played pivotal role in encouraging the World Bank, Asian Development Bank, and the IMF to assist Pakistan whenever we went to seek assistance to these three international financial institutions. I have dealt with these institutions, these three institutions at the highest level for a very long period of time. So I know the how these institutions work. There was a remarks made by, I think, Zameer or General Saab regarding relationship with the IMF or the World Bank, that 6 months ago the World Bank was saying everything is fine, now they're raising alarm bell. So what has changed? It is unfortunate that these two international institutions have become the political arm of the superpower. It is unfortunate. Because these two institutions comprise the best brain, but they are used for certain purpose. And I have seen in my career, when I was dealing with them, the changing nature of the relationship. The same person who used to talk to me started saying, sir, why don't you talk to our headquarters in New York? I can't help anything anymore. So helplessness, you can see, this is the changing priorities. The rating agencies, Moody's and Standard Poor's, when they rate a country, a very large weight is given to the rating that how is the country's relationship with the United States. If the relationship is very close, you get certain high point and which improves your rating, and vice versa. So these are the reasons that why United States are important for Pakistan. If you look at the US financial assistance policy over the years, the stated objective is combating terrorism, developing bilateral military ties, promoting economic growth, and investing in people are the key objectives. This is the stated objectives. This is the background, which I don't want to go into this background of assistantship between the two countries. But let me go to this table. This shows, as I stated earlier, the declining, weakening of economic ties between the two countries. As you can see, approximately one quarter of Pakistan's export used to go to the United States. It has come down to 17%. If you look at the imports has remained more or less in the same range. And this graph will tell you the declining or weakening of economic ties as far as trade is concerned. Let me look at another flows, which is foreign direct investment and remittances. As you can see, foreign direct investment peaked in 2007-2008, $1.3 billion. And then thereafter, as I said, the changing priorities of the United States in this part of the world, it has come down to $13 million in 2015-16, and in 2016-17, it was $71 million. Similarly, on the remittance side, you can see that in 2001-2002, 33%, one-third remittance used to come from the United States, it has come down to about 13% over the years. And this graph will also tell you the yellow one reflects remittances. Sorry, foreign direct investment, and the rising trend, but you can see fluctuation in remittances as well. If you look at the share of total in remittance in Pakistan from the United States, it is on the decline. It has taken over by Saudi Arabia. $5 billion approximately comes from Saudi Arabia in 1 year. This is our Pakistani workers sending to Pakistan. Let me go to this table, which is in recent years, particularly after Tweed. And that is why I'm always in favor that this time we should not go to the IMF. There will be many non-economic prior actions. One of them will be, how did you give sovereign guarantee of $60 billion of worth of loan or investment from China under China CPEC? Do you have money in your pocket? How did you give this guarantee, sovereign guarantee? So, sir, withdraw this guarantee. Do you think that we can withdraw? We are in a position to withdraw guarantee of CPEC financing? This can be one. I'm just giving an example. The other, maybe there can be many other. So bottom line is that we should avoid going to the IMF. But the effort is on from the economic hitman to take Pakistan to a situation that it will have no alternative but to go to the IMF again. If I would have been in the Ministry of Finance, I would have avoided this. And I know how it can be avoided. There are many ways that we can handle this. We have spent so much time in international financial markets, so we can handle it. If you have a good team, good leadership, support from the leadership, some reforms, some bold actions, policy actions, we can weather Pakistan's balance of payment, emerging balance of payment crisis. Maybe in 2-3 days' time, you will see my article on this particular topic in Business Recorder. So, sir, I will end my presentation by simply saying that United States policy has changed since 2005. I was in the government, and I can see the changing priorities since 2005. This pivot Asia policy and India's supremacy in South Asia has been already discussed. US has always maintained a transactional relationship with Pakistan. If you do this, $250 million. If you don't do this, we withheld this $250 million, and so on. You can't maintain this kind of a relationship with sovereigns. The problem is that we have always been blamed for Haqqani network in Pakistan. But seldom we talk about Haqqani network in Washington, D.C., led by Hossein Haqqani. Unfortunately, United States policy is based on Haqqani networks and narratives. Lisa Curtis and Hossein Haqqani have co-authored a report on US-Pakistan's relationship, and that report is being implemented because Lisa Curtis is now dealing with, one of the co-authors is dealing with the US policy towards South Asia, which includes Pakistan. So Haqqani network is active. So as long as United States continue to take guidance from the Haqqani network in Washington, D.C., there cannot be a stable relationship between U.S. and Pakistan. This is the bottom line, sir. Thank you very much.